The end of the prelude, the suite number one. Yes, it is in the fourth position, and you must have a strong understanding of the fourth position prior to attempting the prelude to the number one suite by Bach. This position right here is one that you must master. Why? Because you are able to play these lower register notes here on the next string over on the same string. I suggest that you check out this book. It is linked in the description below. It is a fantastic supplementary to any of you that are going from beginner to intermediate cellists, and it's written by a cellist for a cellist. Let's learn the fourth position. Let's start with the warm-up. Don't be alarmed by the French, it just means warm-up. We're going to start with the open A, and then a fingered A, then the open A, and then the A here, which is on the C string, fourth position. They're all A's. In the next two measures, it's the same, all G's. Start open G, then one here on the C, back to open G, then four here on the A. And the last measure, we have a G and a G, a G, a C, and then the last C was here, that is a C. So remember those positions. Moving on to the very first etude, the green brackets simply mean, in my pedagogy, the fourth position. You don't find green brackets in the second line, because I expect you to learn. So we're gonna follow along, open A, then here 1-4-1, then shifting back. No bracket means first position. Shift. Back up. And repeat just like that for the second measure. Quite simple. The next etude, number two, you want to be able to shift back and forth between the fourth and the first position. It's the four here that you're landing, and it's a four here that you're landing. So make sure you're nice and accurate, and you're keeping your hand small when you go up here and making your hand larger when you go back to first position. It starts here with an open G, the two G's, and then two D's. This is a G, and this is a D. Now we continue on in fourth position. And repeat that for the second line. It's really quite easy. Here's the last two measures. I know it seems silly to do a one and then an open A, but these are etudes. These are exercises Mr. Mooney has given to us in order to learn this position properly. Thank you for watching my video on the fourth position. Such an essential position for us as cello players. And please, if you do want to continue with the exercises, there are many more with the fourth position, please purchase this book, The Rick Mooney Position Pieces, Volume 1, which you can find linked in the description below. Simply click on the link and purchase it right there. I have already done the work for you. I really support this. I am not being compensated in any way by the publisher. I just believe in the pedagogy. It's helped out so many countless students of mine in real life. And now I pass on this knowledge to you on YouTube. So thank you for watching. Please like and subscribe and share with a student that is trying and maybe struggling with the fourth position. The next one I'm going to cover will be here, the upper third position. Another third position, a great one to learn for any of those sharps. I'm talking your A majors and your D majors, anything that has a sharp, well, this is really going to help you out. So stick around a while. I think you're going to learn a lot.